Where are we?
That's good.
Things seem to go probably how a lot of people expected them to go for your first fight in this thing. Did it go that the way you expected it to go too?
The way I expected it to go, yeah, for sure. It went the way I expected it to go. I was hoping for a finish in the first round. I was hoping for a quick finish. It wasn't that quick. If it was about like 1 minute 35 seconds, I believe, 37, something like that. I was hoping for something quicker, so that way nobody could beat and I could just be like leading the rankings. But it was so quick, it was so good enough. I believe that I'm still leading, even though like, you know, the fight, the night's not over yet. But you know, I believe that when you train really hard, when you prepare yourself, when you give like 100% like of your time, like dedication, like, you know, stop like spending time with your family so you can just train and like, you know, be ready for something, you get the results you want. And my confidence level when I walked into that cage, like it was just like, you know, to another level. There was nobody that could beat me, like, you know, at the moment. And I have like 5 weeks now to train for the next fight. So it's gonna be like a 19 weeks training camp, which nobody does. Everybody's gonna be taking like 2 days off. I'm not. I'm gonna go back to the hotel right now. I'm gonna get a workout. So when I'm gonna be training again, twice. And then nobody's gonna beat me. It's gonna be tough.
I mean, you bloody a guy up, you choke him out in like 90 seconds, and your first reaction is, oh man, that should have been faster. Is that what you're kind of telling us here?
It's not that I'm underestimating anybody. It's just the fact that I've been training really hard for it. So of course I'm gonna expect the best like from myself. And the fact that I've achieved so much like my career as an athlete, not in MMA, but like in overall, like in jiu-jitsu, like in grappling, I have to believe that I have the potential to do the same in the cage, as long as I dedicate myself like into it. And I have done this for like, you know, at least for this tournament, like I've done more than I've ever done like my career.
How important is it to remind everybody in the division that, hey, I'm the guy that will choke you out, you know, in a hurry? I mean, everybody knows that about you, but it feels like you need to put a stamp on it to remind everybody right away in this tournament.
I feel people know that they cannot mess with me on the ground. When it comes to the ground game, you know, there's going to be like, I'll give another guy who actually happens to be my teammate, and I hope that both of us are going to end up like as number one, number two, like in this tournament, which is Ronnie Marcus. But everybody else, nobody can mess with neither one of us on the ground, and they know that. It's a fact, you know, it cannot be denied. That cannot be denied. When it comes to credentials, I have the best credentials on the ground than anybody else in the division. And I feel like it's a simple strategy, you know. As long as I'm ready to take people down, I can work my striking like well enough to like, you know, make people like not want to actually strike with me. When it goes to the ground, it's gonna be like, you know, just the way it was.
The way the point system is set up in this whole thing, I mean, it seems kind of custom built for a guy like you who's able to finish guys the majority of the time that he fights. How important was it to get 6 points tonight instead of just 5 or 4 or even just 3?
Well, here's the thing with the points too. I was not looking just to get a finish, like maybe like a third round, get those like would it be 4 points? I want to get those 6 points. So, you know, my whole mindset was to try to go there, get the guy down like right away and get a finish. And again, it played out perfectly the way I wanted it. And I can't complain about anything.
You've been around, you've fought in the biggest promotions. How huge would it be to go all the way through this thing and to win it and get that $1 million?
You know, the funniest thing is like a lot of people are thinking about the money, which I would lie, like would be lying really bad if I said that it wasn't the money the major factor for me to be doing this. But, you know, something just happened that I was like, man, like, you know, everybody questions like my, you know, school as an MMA fighter. Nobody questions my school as a grappler, you know, it's proven. I don't need to prove anything to anybody else. But it's funny how people say, oh, he's not as good. It's like, no, maybe, you know, when you saw me fight, I wasn't training as much as I should, you know. Maybe there are other things like happened on the side that kept me from like, you know, reach my full potential. And then for this tournament, like, you know, for the last like 14 weeks, there's nothing like on my way, you know. There's no stress like outside with family or, you know, financial stress. There's nothing, you know, everything just went perfectly and there's no injuries. There's nothing stopping from like performing my best. And the result was like 1 minute 30 seconds and 35 seconds.
So you feel like you're peaking right now in your whole career. This is maybe the best you've ever felt.
Mentally, for sure. There's nothing like compared to like, you know, maybe there were like, you know, when I went on a 6-fight winning streak, when I actually got signed back to the UFC, I was doing really well, you know, everything was like, but it was different. Like when you're young, like, you know, you believe that you can beat anybody in the world. It's just like that mindset. For me now, it's the experience that makes me believe that I can beat anybody in the world. Because I know like, you know, what kind of mistakes I've made like to, you know, fail my career like at a certain point. And I'm not willing to commit those same mistakes anymore.
Appreciate it. Good luck on the second one, man.
Thank you.
Hey, Vinny, you mentioned a little bit ago about you and Honey Marks. If it ends up that you guys got to fight each other, how is that going to play out?
Me and Ronnie, we fight each other every day in the gym. So it's like, you know, it's just like we actually happen to sign up in the same tournament. And we are friends. We're going to still be friends if we have to fight. But then again, I truly believe that both of us can be number one, number two. So hopefully you're not going to be meeting each other into the final. So we're good. You know, as far as that, I'm not even thinking of that. I believe that runner is going to finish his fight tonight, and then you're going to be a really high rank, so you don't have to worry about each other right now. And there's no way they would have been matched up the next fight. Mm. So I'm not worried about Honey right now.
And just real quickly, I mean, you locked that up, and there was no doubt in my mind that you were going to finish it, but did you have any doubts at all when a fight goes to the ground? I mean, 100% you're going to finish it, or...?
My biggest thing with like the fight going to the ground sometimes is not like that I believe that I cannot finish, but it really depends on my conditioning. And like I said, for this fight, there's no issue with that. You know, I've been training so much that conditioning was not going to be a factor. And then when he went to the ground, the only thing that was bothering me was his blood. He just got so slippery. So I had the rear naked like sunk in like right away under his chin. But he was getting so slippery because of the blood, I had to really like muscle out. It wasn't even like a perfect, pure, like clean technique. I just used muscle to like squeeze him and, you know, make him tap. But it's one of those things, when I'm on the ground, I feel like I have an advantage top or bottom. So at one point when I felt like he was about to escape the rear naked, I was already getting prepared to go to my back and work on something off my back. So it's not like, you know, I'm not worried about something, but ideally, things would happen just the way they happen. Like, you know, lock submission and get it right away without having to, like, you know, spend energy with something else.
Thank you for your time, Vinny.
Thank you.
Vinny, congratulations on the big victory.